You may have gotten an alert or a message on your phone this morning warning you that a quake was about to hit. They were pushed to phones across Northern California, but there are questions about who got the alert and why. Gulston Dart joins us in studio to explain. Gulston.
Yeah, I got one. It was like, what the heck's going on when it went off? The emergency alert lit up phones all over the area, and it said that an earthquake was imminent, and many people never even felt the shaking, me included, and now they're wondering why they got the warning. So those alerts are based on the USGS Shake Alert System. They go out to cell phones through the MyShake app, FEMA's Wireless Emergency Alert System, and Android Alerts. The message pops up before the shaking begins. It's supposed to give you just a little chance there. It's supposed to go out for any quake above magnitude 5.0. So what happened today when the quake was only a 4.2? Well, a project scientist for the Earthquake Early Warning Department at the Berkeley Seismological Laboratory says that this all has to do with their initial estimate, which put the quake initially at 5.7. So that was strong enough at the time to trigger the alert. So she says in this case, the system worked just like it was supposed to, but there is room for improvement.
So our Shake Alert Earthquake Early Warning System is trying to calculate the magnitudes as quickly as it can. We use just a very tiny amount of information to predict how big the earthquake is. We do this within seconds, and this is so we can give you as much warning as possible. The downside to doing that means that sometimes when we create the initial estimate, it comes in high. So for this particular event, we did create a magnitude estimate initially, magnitude 5.7, definitely a little high. I always like to see us do a little bit better job with the magnitude estimate, so I will say that we definitely overestimated the magnitude there. However, the good thing about the system is that everything worked exactly as it should, other than that magnitude estimate. And sometimes in order to warn the people who are gonna feel that strongly shaking, again, we're getting those magnitude estimates out as quickly as we can, and sometimes that does mean that we create a little bit of an overestimate to start.
She says that sometimes they do overestimate. Well, she says that they'll now look at algorithms to see how any of this can possibly be improved. And by the way, a test is scheduled for tomorrow for the MyShake alert. This was already planned before the quake that happened today. So that's still set to go ahead. So expect your phone to go off tomorrow. That will be a test alert, but at least now we know.